When it comes to performing at your best, on the field, in the office, or at home, what percentage of it do you think is mental? 30%, 40%, a little less, a little more? Well, Lanny Bassham, who is an Olympic gold medalist, he's an author, a teacher, and a coach to some of the best performers, parents, and leaders on the planet. He says it's 90%, that 90% of our performance is mental. When I reflect on my own performance, past, present, and future, as a teacher, as a college athlete, as a spouse, and a YouTuber and business owner, I tend to agree. Lenny says that we're all born with seeds of greatness within us, and that the primary differences that separates the winners and others is the way we think, especially the way we think about ourselves. Yet, when we want to improve our performance, improve our lives, our relationships, where do we typically focus our time and energy? Is it on mental skills? More often than not, we focus our energy, our time, and our efforts on finding new resources, on creating a great strategy, on developing new skills. We don't typically spend a lot of time working on our mental game. Whether we're trying to win a World Cup, close a $10 deal, a $10 million deal, write a book, be a great parent, a great coach, a great leader, make great YouTube videos. Lenny's mental management system gives us a process to maximize the probability of having consistent mental performance under pressure and on demand. In today's video, I'm going to share with you the three components of his mental management system. And over the next couple of days, I'm going to share with you some of my favorite ideas from his great book, With Winning in Mind. Hello, and welcome back to the Making Hope Happen series. I'm Lori Mage. This is day 50, woohoo, 50 of the 100 day challenge where I'm stacking my energy, my work, and my love goals. And I'm sharing 100 of my favorite tools, tips, and ideas to help you and me more effectively navigate change, master our transitions, and make our dreams come true. Thank you for joining me today. I really appreciate you being here. Let's jump in. With Winning in Mind is one of the most transformational books I've ever read. Now, there are a handful of books that I go back to again and again and again, and Lenny's book is one of those books. And I would not be exaggerating when I say that this book has literally changed my life. And as you can see, I've used this book quite a bit. There's lots of notes inside. This book has been on more vacations with me, more business trips with me than any other book that I own. That said, this book may not be for everyone, but the mental management training system that's taught in this book is. And since writing this book, Lenny has also written a bunch of different books, including his mental management system that goes along with it. And he's geared it towards parenting, towards coaching, leadership, and specific sports like bowling and golf, and a whole bunch of other ones. Now, what are the three components of this mental management system that's gonna help us perform consistently, even under pressure? What I want you to do is to imagine three different circles. The first circle is our conscious mind, the second circle is our subconscious mind, and the third circle is our self-image. Now, the system includes all three of these, and it teaches us how to integrate these three different components and develop each of them to their fullest potential while being careful to balance the growth between them. If we don't pay attention, one component might grow faster than the other component, and it's going to create all kinds of problems for us, and it's going to inhibit our ability to consistently perform at our best at work, at home, or on the field. So the first component is our conscious mind, and this has to do with our thoughts. It has to do with our mental pictures, and it controls all the other senses, like what we focus our seeing on, our hearing, smelling, tasting, and touching. It's essentially what we picture or think about in our minds. And the conscious mind is what we use to clarify what success looks like for us, how we define our goals, what we determine our priorities, and it's establishing timeframes. Now, the second part is our subconscious mind. And the subconscious mind is the source of our skills and our powers to perform in the moment. Almost all great performance is accomplished through the subconscious mind. Almost all performance accomplishments is done through the subconscious mind. People, when they're performing at their best, they're not thinking, they're not in their conscious mind. Take Michael Jordan, for example, back in the day. When he was dribbling down the court, he was not thinking about the championship. He was not thinking dribble, 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 dribble when he was pushing the ball at the court. He wasn't thinking about anything. He was fully present in the moment, letting his body perform the way it was trained to perform without any conscious thought interrupting his performance. And he developed this high performance instinct and this skill and this power through conscious repetition, until that conscious repetition turned into the subconscious mind, where it would automate it and perform it without thinking about it. that's when we perform best. We use our conscious mind to determine what to focus on, and then we, through repetition, train our subconscious mind to take over and perform at its best. Now, the third component is the self-image, and it's essentially what makes you act like you. It's the total of your habits and your attitudes. Our performance and our self-image are always equal. You will never outperform your self-image. The self-image, Lenny says, is the most important component of these three different circles, and it's usually the one that gets the least amount of attention. You may have a conscious goal to become debt-free, to double your income, to start your own business, or lose 50 pounds. And you may even have some subconscious skills and power to do it, but if you don't have the self-image or the belief that you're the kind of person that can actually do these things, you almost have no chance of accomplishing your dreams and goals. And even if you do, if your self-image doesn't match your performance, you won't be able to sustain it. So when it comes to you navigating the changes you're going through and the goals that you have that you're aspiring to achieve this year, how are you doing in each of these three performance areas? Do you have a clear picture about what you want, as well as when and why and how you want to achieve it? That's your conscious mind. Are you consciously putting in the reps every single day to develop the skills and the powers that you're going to need to perform the way you need to perform to achieve what it is you want to achieve and accomplish? That's your subconscious mind. And do you see yourself and believe yourself to be the kind of person who's capable and worthy of that greatness you see, of that goal you're going after? That's your self-image. I'd say for most of my life, that third component, self-image, has been sabotaging my performance and keeping me from achieving some of my bigger dreams and goals that I have for myself. My conscious mind, that seems to be wide awake and firing on all cylinders. I know what I want. I have a clear mental picture to prove it. And over the years, I've developed my skills and power to be one of the best in my field as a teacher and as a coach. But my self-image has not grown with my skills or my dreams. So according to this model, the highest leverage point I have right now is I've got to grow that self-image to match the skills and to match the dreams, and then start to systematically build all three of them and integrate them together. So how about you? Which of the three do you need to work on? Which of the three are you really good at already? Well, that's it for today. That's Lanny Bassham's three-part mental model system. It's a system that has helped him and others show up consistently as their best, and even when the pressure's on, to win over a dozen gold medals, to parent some of the world's best champions, to lead successful startups, and much, much more. If you got value today, give me a thumbs up, leave a comment below, share this video with others, and if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I'm gonna be back tomorrow with more tools, tips, and ideas from Lenny's great book, With Winning in Mind, to help us improve our ability to navigate change, master our transitions, and make our dreams come true. I hope you have an awesome night, and I will see you tomorrow.